Welcome to this quick introduction to the confusion matrix. If you've ever looked at a confusion matrix for the first time, you might have found it, well, confusing. But it doesn't have to be. A confusion matrix is a simple way to lay out how many predicted categories or classes were correctly predicted and how many were not. It is used to evaluate the results of a predictive model with a class outcome to see the number of classes that were correctly predicted as their true class. To understand what's going on inside this confusion matrix of correct classes versus incorrect classes, we first need to understand true positives, true negatives, false positives, and false negatives. Kind of confusing, right? Well, let's relabel these terms to make it a bit clearer. Essentially, the confusion matrix is just keeping track of class A correctly predicted as class A, class B correctly predicted as class B, class A incorrectly predicted as class B, and class B incorrectly predicted as class A. Where true and false comes into it is we want to know if our target class A was correctly predicted as A, which is true, or incorrectly predicted as B, when it in fact was A, which is false. Our target class A is our positive and the other class B is our negative. So then a true positive and a true negative is a positive class A correctly predicted as class A and negative class B correctly predicted as B. We want to get as many predictions of A and B as possible, aiming for more trues rather than falses. So then how do we organize this in a way to lay out the number of correct A's and B's versus incorrect A's and B's? Well, we draw a grid. We place these into a matrix grid where the x-axis is the predictions made and the y-axis is the actual class label. So let's just say we have 200 subjects, of which 100 are from class A and 100 from class B. 60 of actual A cases on the y-axis were correctly predicted as their true class, A, on the x-axis. For class B, 30 actual B classes on the y-axis were truly predicted as class B on the x-axis. If you look at the diagonal counts, that's how many subjects were correctly predicted as their classes. So these are all the trues for the positive and negative classes. So now you have a way of identifying which class is predicted correctly most of the time compared to other classes, and evaluate whether your predictive model is, you know, guessing right most of the time, or is it guessing wrong on each of these classes. One last thing. How do we decide what is class A and what is class B? What should be the positive class and what should be the negative class? Well, most of the time it doesn't matter which class you assign to positive or negative, as the confusion matrix will tell you how many subjects were correctly, you know, predicted from each class. But here are some examples of a target class you might want to differentiate from a non-target class. In standard binary classification, you could be interested in returning customers as, you know, the positive target class versus new customers as the negative class. Or it could be one target class versus all other classes, such as aggressive cancer versus all other passive type cancers as the single negative class. Either way, you're comparing how many were correctly or incorrectly classified from each class. The confusion matrix will tell you how many times actual class A was predicted as B and vice versa, or if they were correctly, you know, classed as their true labels. And that sums up the confusion matrix. Thanks for watching. Give us a like if you found it useful, or you can check out our other video tutorials at Data Science Dojo Tutorials.